Greetings, webbies. Let's create a basic web page using Dreamweaver and Bootstrap. Here's the page layout plan. Our client would like something like this. So we're going to start breaking this down in our mind. Next, we'll mock up the basic layout into sections. We see a navigation area at the very top, followed by a header, a main area with three content areas, and then a footer. Now we'll need to break that up into Bootstrap components. We'll need a container, a row with one column, another row with one column, the next row with three columns, and finally the last row with one column. Now let's think about how we can apply the semantics to our components. We'll replace the first column with a navbar component, and our second header row will contain column that's the full 12 columns of the grid wide. Our third main row will contain an aside column, an article column, and another aside column, for the moment each four columns wide. Lastly, a column 12 wide inside our footer row, all of this contained in our container. It's time to create a new document. On the top right of your Dreamweaver interface, click File, then click New. On the page that opens, select New Document, click HTML, and then the Bootstrap tab. Click the Create New button, uncheck Include a pre-built layout, click Customize, but let's leave the default settings, and then click Create. Let's go ahead and save. Click File, Save As, locate and click on your destination folder, name your file, be sure not to include any spaces, click Save, and then confirm that the file has saved in the location that you desire. Click Refresh if necessary. Sometimes it doesn't show up right away in your file panel. Notice that Bootstrap has created a CSS folder, a JS folder, and a fonts folder. You wouldn't do this in the real world, but for this class, I suggest that you move those folders inside the lesson folder that you're working on. That way, when you start another Bootstrap project in another lesson, that you won't have conflicting folders. Take a minute to observe the code in the new Bootstrap page that you have created. Review the content of HTML code, paying special attention to the external links. Click on the live page and you'll see a tag that says body. In the right of your Dreamweaver interface, near the Files panel, you'll see another tab that says Insert. To find the component options in the drop-down menu, select Bootstrap Components. The Bootstrap Component menu opens, revealing over 20 options. This time, you're going to select the first one, Container. Reviewing your code and your live view, you'll now have a div class container inside your body tag. In version 3 of Dreamweaver, you have four size options: extra small, small, medium, and large. We're opting for small, so you want to make sure that you click on the 768 min width in your virtual media query interface. Depending on the size of your computer screen, you may have to close all your panels to icons and open just in live view without your code view showing to make sure that you can select the 768 min pixel small. Check after you insert the first element and be sure that you have the small. If you've got medium or extra small, you just didn't click in the right place. So once you've selected the size and you can see div container showing in the live window, select the grid row with column from the Bootstrap components options. Be sure to click on or near the icon. If you click in the text, sometimes it doesn't make the connection. Select carefully when your select row with column window pops up. You can adjust your column number and select the row location, nest, after, or before. Stop and confirm that everything is in the correct place. Your container needs to be inside the body opening and closing tags, and your div class row with the column inside needs to be nested inside the container. Again, all row column sets should be nested inside the container tags.
Row column sets come one after the other in the layout, followed at the very end by the container closing tag. Get in the habit of checking to make sure that all of your components are where they should be. Finally, you'll be adding semantic structure. Follow directions carefully, as always.